Hi everybody, this is Arthur and Dot Features. Today we have something special for you. Get ready for the future that Robonomics can show us right now. Robonomics is the ready-to-work and open-source platform which you can use to connect your robot as a service for end users. They call it Robot as a Service. Robonomics support web-free technologies that implement the exchange of technical and economic information between humans and machines. Robonomics is a purely technical and open-source project. The project opens for developers and new audience of users, roboticists. Do you want to become a roboticist? No matter what you answer, we will face the huge request for roboticists in near future. Meet the developer of Robonomics and cool roboticist Vadim Manaenko. Master's degree in robotics, has been studying in ITMO University Russia, joined Robonomics in 2017 as a junior engineer. His main duties are creating demonstrations and connecting different kinds of robots to the Robonomics network, as well as providing source code, documentations, and maintaining these use cases. Welcome, Vadim. We have a lot of questions for you, if you are ready.
Yeah, I'm ready. Hello, everyone. Hi.
So, my first question is, Robonomics linked Ethereum and Polkadot with the robot operating system. The number of roboticists familiar with ROS is about 22,000 developers. What does Robonomics and robot operating system provide? What are the key functions of the system?
Okay, so basically ROS, it stands for Robotic Operating System. It's a large set of packages for robotics needs. And also it comes with a publisher-subscriber architecture that allows you to build a complex package, a complex system, dividing those into a set of small nodes and creating the communication via predefined messages. And the Robonomics network supports ROS from the very beginning, and it means that any ROS-enabled robot could be easily connected to the Robonomics network. The goal of Robonomics is to provide a way to connect a different type of cyber physical systems for machine to machine or human to machine communication. And SCPS could be a sensor, a set of sensors. It could be a flying drone, an industrial manipulator, or the whole factory. For the Robonomics, it doesn't matter. And what Robonomics does is it makes it possible to create a robot economy and to let those CPSs exchange transactions with the task and the money at the same time.
Mm-hmm. All right, great. So a lot of people saw the video Kusama on Mars. He was a part of it. Can you tell us about some of your experiments? What was the goal and what were the results?
The video was a result of our work during the Hakusama event, and the demonstration shows how a dedicated blockchain could live on a different planet and still being a parachain could finalize blocks on Earth. First of all, we examined the agreement of countries on how to behave when it comes to the moon or to the other celestial bodies. And the document was published in 1979. And we examined the document and implemented a few articles of it. Besides of the software part, where we deployed the relay chain, where we registered this parachain, we also assembled the rover. And the telemetry from the rover was intended to be published in the blockchain as a result of the rover's work. Also, we made an expedition to Mars and we set a base camp. And the base camp was equipped with a set of sensors that collected some measurements. And those measurements was as well transmitted to the distributed file system and to Parachain as well.
Fascinating stuff. You had an experiment with the robot painter Gakkachu. Here is the working process and results of Gakkachu. Can you tell us some funny moments of robots and humans interacting?
Yes, there is a manipulator, Kuka, And the Gakkachu name stands for, Gakka is basically a painter from Japanese, and Chu is like, we consider it as a Pokemon. Unfortunately, I wasn't the developer of the project, but I'm aware of a few issues, and one of them was, at the beginning, we didn't know a good algorithm to draw this continuous line. Instead, the robot painted the picture pixel by pixel, but then it got mature, it learned new skills, and in the end, it learned how to do these curvy motions. Also, once it died because of an operating system fault, and we had to call an engineer to fix it. And one could think of this robot as an alive creature that lives, that learns new skills, and sometimes it's sick, and when it's sick, you call a doctor.
All right, so why did you choose two networks, Ethereum and Polkadot, and what do you prefer?
In the beginning, Ethereum was the only network with the smart contracts that suited our needs. But over time, it was obvious that the bandwidth is too low and the transaction fees are too high. In the end, it still suits us when it comes to connect a large CPS, a large cyber-physical system to the network, like let's say a factory, or to issue a digital passport. So basically any scenario when there is no requirements for a lot of transactions. From the other hand, Polkadot promises a way more number of transactions per second and new opportunities to create a custom blockchain.
There are smart contracts and Robonomics. If we need to connect smart contracts, robots and the real world, what do we need to step by step?
If we speak about Robonomics over Ethereum network that is stable currently, then there is no need for a user to deploy a smart contract by itself. We already developed a collection of smart contracts and deployed it to the network, and they are ready to use. And all of the work is built on exchanging those IPFS messages. So let's say we have one party, your service, a robot, and all you have to do is to teach the robot how to understand those messages, how to interact with them, how to respond to them. From the other side, we have usually a DAPP. It could be for a user decentralized application, or we have another service. And we have so-called providers, and the provider does the work, actually. So it listens to those messages, and when it finds two corresponding messages, it creates a liability smart contract for you and puts all of the information about the liability within the smart contract, the information like the cost, the hash of the task, addresses of parties. Also, liability smart contract is responsible for keeping the tokens until the work is finished. And when the robot does its job, it signals with the result message, and then the tokens are transferred to the CPS address. So basically, you just need to teach the robot the service, how to interact with those messages, and the network does all the rest.
Okay, got it. When will we see commercial integrations and factories factories operating under the robot operating system? What are your predictions?
According to Gartner, it's an analytical agency, in the next 3-5 years, more than 70% of all of the IoT solutions will be redesigned by companies. And we think that this is our integration window. For 2015, we were too futuristic, and to be honest, we still are. But this time, we are closer to the user's needs. And consider this, back to 2015, no one has expected autopilot cars on the road in 2020, but here we are. And we hope that this is the case for blockchain technologies, in IoT solutions, for 2020-25.
Mm-hmm. So When we were preparing for this video, we found this. It is so cute. Everyone should read it and show it to the kids. Who is the illustrator of the book and other cool stuff Robonomics have? Can you share the story of this book?
Yes, the illustrator is Anna Vimir Savinova. Anna, hi. Probably you noticed that Polkadot has a light paper. This is a simplified version of what the technology is. And I think everyone understands that more and more people are becoming more interested in how it works for those complex projects. And those people who are outside of the field of the issue, like journalists or token holders or users, they are willing to understand how it works, but there is no need for them to see what's hidden under the hood. And such books as ours is like a children's night book that is simple, but yet it remains dry as a scientific article that explains all of the stuff.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's talk a little bit about tokenomics. What is XRT and how it will be used in the network? How do you spread the tokens to make the system decentralized? I saw the great tokenomics file. We can show it. We can show it and walk through it with your comments.
The XRT is it's the main Robonomics token. Basically, XRT is an utility token that your robotics or IoT solution could use to pay a transaction fee. It's also a default payment token, but if you're building your custom service for the Robonomics network, you can use any ERC20 token as a payment token. Also, currently we are working on bringing this functionality to Polkadot ecosystem. And besides of the XRT token, we have another token that is called RWS. And basically RWS is a lifetime subscription token that gives you one transaction per second free of charge for the use of Robonomics network functionality. And to learn more about the tokenomics, about comparison of these two tokens, how they relate, I suggest you to go to our blog and read. There are a lot of great articles from Sergey Lanshakov about the topic.
Thank you, Vadim, for joining us. And we will have the great example of the use case of Robonomics and explain how smart contracts work. Thank you again for your time. Thank you.